live, eh?
So started to cut the asparagus fern down now. And what I found underneath, I have the first asparagus growing. The first shoot come out. So it might be earlier than we actually expected to have asparagus already growing. We're planning to cut all this off, everything, and cover up with my pack, so it'll be earlier. But I can see it's early enough anyway, isn't it? Will be early enough, isn't it?
We should be by the end of February, we should have asparagus.
Wow, that's fantastic. That's hard.
They fall over everywhere. Every 3 days, you've got to be...
So that's how we do it. We put the compost, we clean it up. The asparagus, it's clean now. It's nice and ready to be cut. Of course, not ready to be cut, but will be ready to be cut. It started shooting. So I've got now the compost here in the rows. I'm going to do on every row like this. With the compost, then we should put my packs in between, so the weeds are not gonna grow as mad again as they used to last year, because this side wasn't growing before, like I was saying, and had a lot of weed seeds in it, and they alive until how many years the weeds? 25 years the seeds, like the weed seeds, can stay alive and still come up. So we need to cover it, the ground. We tried it with our covering, it doesn't work.
But this was so, all brambles and all overgrown.
Oh yes, this was all brambles. I've got Chris here. Yes, and here was all overgrown. And
it's all brambles, all overgrown. And so this is near enough like virgin soil.
Yes, but it's nice, isn't it?
The soil is nice. It's just it's got a lot of weed seeds in there. That yes. We just need to suppress without chemicals.
Yes.
So by putting Mypex on the walkways and just leaving a small space about 30 centimetres so that the asparagus can grow through, then we can cover that with enough either our spent compost, reuse it, or we'll have spent mushroom compost, so we have a deep pile, maybe 3-4 inches, 10 centimetres, so that'll stop the weeds from growing where the asparagus is.
Yeah, and that will be then not so labor intense now. Look how nice it'll be looking. So we cut the bay of asparagus already, This one we don't cut because this last year we sow it from seeds and we let it grow and build up, as you see. But this is the day of harvest on my asparagus, and asparagus needs cutting every day or every other day, which is a lot of asparagus actually from one bay. Looking lovely, isn't it? So as you can see, I've got two varieties of asparagus. One that it's mauve. So this one is mauve, you can see, and the other variety is green. So that's two types of asparagus this year, and for the next year we're planning to have three varieties, because we're gonna be the third variety, we're gonna be white asparagus. So all it's left now is to bunch my asparagus up in the bunches. We weighing up and then put two elastic bands, sometimes one elastic band around it. And today is a Wednesday, so tomorrow morning it's ready to be sold in our farm shop. And then we shall pick tomorrow and the next day for Cambridge Market. Cambridge Market is on Sundays. So we're gonna pick the rest few days for Cambridge Market as well. So the asparagus is picked. It's Wednesday today. We have picked loads of asparagus, and then I'm going now to bunch it up, as I said. And look at these beauties. Look at these cucumbers. It's called gherkin cucumbers. Fantastic. We just picked today now from our glass house. So next is the lettuce to be picked, and then kohlrabi, celery, and all the other things, which is very nice to keep it fresh. We pick it today, which is a Wednesday, and tomorrow it's a Thursday, and the farm shop is open. Then we do exactly the same with our market produce. We pick it the day before and then sell it the next day on the market.